37 minutes past the hour right now. It could be really the biggest earthquake yet waiting to strike.
Could it be? I wonder. In the last 12 months, Chile, New Zealand, now Japan.
Exactly when and where, you find out more information after the fact than beforehand. But if you're looking at history as a guide, we're due, or that particular fault line is due.
You would think so. I mean, you've got the San Andreas fault.
Was there, I mean, I guess we can't, or can we know that it was more than just coincidence that there were these, that the other seismic activity before 1906, or is it sort of a scientific foreshadowing?
It's...
Especially as you talk about, is it proper to say the subduction zone, like underneath in the ocean for the Cascadian?
The Cascadia is the important
right.
one. It's the one that's very little known about.
After all of the changes they made since 1989?
22 years since the Loma Prieta earthquake. Uh-huh. Still,
I mean, waiting for the big one to hit California. People who live in California either joke about it or fear about it. Fear
exactly.
it, depending on where you stand. When you look at Japan, Japan has, it's the same size, a little bit less than the size of California, with four times as many people. So when you think about the number of people packed in Japan and how that destruction has been so widespread, what would it look like in California if we had the next big one?
Well, it depends.
In Japan, in Sendai, you were talking 13 or 30?
Well, there was one 10 meters in Sendai, that was 30 mm-hmm. feet.
Okay. If in fear, obviously, you can't control the events of Mother Nature, but you can be aware and maybe have in the back of your mind of what you would do in those cases. And then on the flip side, as you said, in terms of getting San Francisco or other areas along that fault line ready, I mean, in Japan, they withstand very large earthquakes, and their buildings withstand very large earthquakes. Nearly constantly.
Yes, I mean,
very interesting article in Newsweek, and again, as you said, you did write the Krakatoa interesting book as well. Simon Winchester, thanks for your
Simon.
Time.
Thank you very much indeed.
We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.